Okay, in this video, I'm going to show you how to solve the challenge 2 in the lab 3. So first, we open the lab instruction. So the challenge 2 in lab 3 is retrieve the data from the sales table. Yeah. So we have three tasks. Yeah. Retrieve the list all customers and the orders. And then retrieve the list of the customers with the no address. And then retrieve the list of the customers and product without the orders. Yeah, okay, so I'm going to copy this instruction and then I put that in the query. Okay, then after that just comment this. Okay, so let's start with the first, which is the retrieving the list of the customers and their orders. Yeah, so the managers want to get the list of the all customer companies and their contacts. Yeah, first name, last name, showing the sales order ID and the total due for the each order they have to place, and the customers who have not placed any orders should be included as well at the bottom of the list. Yeah, with the null value for the order ID and then total due. Yeah, so we going to create a query from the multiple tables with the join. Then after that, the join is including the left. So we use the outer left join. Yeah. So that's what we are going to create. Yeah. So we create a skeleton of the query. Select. Yeah. After that, from. The from is from the customer. Yeah. So this one. Yeah. And then after that join, yeah, so left join, and then the table is the sales order header where we can get the order amount. Yeah, and then after that we going to sort, yeah, the order by the sales order ID. The sales order ID from this, and then descending, because we want to place the null, yeah, the customer with the order null order, yeah, without order in the bottom. Yeah, so we sort by the order ID and then descending. Okay, then here we are going to complete. Yeah, so with what we want to display is just know company name, first name, last name, order ID and the total due. Yeah, from this explanation. So company name and then first name, last name, then sales order ID and then also the total due. Yeah, so I put the here from the customer table. So we need to include the company name. Yeah, so the company name, which is this one. Yeah, and then after that the first name and then also the last name. So this one, and then last name is this one. You can type, yeah, but you can drag and drop as well. Yeah, and then from the order, I will sales order ID include this one, and then also the total due. Yeah, so total due is this one. Okay, yeah, so this is the column. Yeah, then after that I'm going to include the table name on each column. Yeah, so for the customer I put SC, and then for the sales order header I put the OH. Yeah, like this. So this is C company name. Yeah, and then C first name, and then C last name, and then OH sales order ID, and then OH total due, like this. Okay, yeah, then after that from the this one left join, and then put the on. Yeah, so the connecting column is the from the customer. We have the this one, yeah, customer ID, and then after that here so the order. Yeah, in the sales order we have the customer ID as well. Let's look at the customer ID. This one, yeah. So we specify the C, yeah, customer ID, and then OH customer ID, like this, yeah. Okay, then run the query. Okay, yeah, this is the answer for the. So the customer data never place order will be displayed in the bottom, yeah, with the this the null order ID and total queue, yeah. Okay, so the second is to retrieve the list of the customer with the no address, yeah. So the sales employee has noticed that ActionWorks does not have the address information for the all customer. You want to select only the customer that does not have the address, yeah. Okay, so here I'm going to retrieve what the column name that you need, yeah. So here customer ID, company name, yeah, and then the contact name, first name and last name, and then also the phone number. Okay, so let's do that, yeah. Again, I write the skeleton of the query, yeah, select after that from, yeah. So what you need to select the column that you want to include is a company name, and then after that the comma, first name, and then last name, and then also the phone, yeah. So all of this from the basically the sales LT customer. Okay, yeah. So after that we put the condition, yeah, the company that does not have the address. So we are going to use the left join and then connect this table with the sales LT customer address, yeah. So look for the customer address, this is the one, yeah, left join sales LT customer address, yeah, and then we put the alias CA customer address, yeah, on. Okay, so here I put the customer address, the column is a customer ID, yeah. So on the C dot customer ID equal to the CA, yeah, dot the customer ID too, yeah, this one. Okay, so C customer ID, C is the customer, yeah, you have this customer ID, yeah. Okay, so maybe I just replace this with the this one, it's better, yeah. C dot customer ID. Okay, so I have not defined the C, so that's the reason why this underline, yeah. So I put the S C here. Okay, yeah, then you specify the condition, yeah, where the CA dot address ID is null. Yeah, so this one is the condition, yeah, to bring the customer without address. Okay, so if you put the this one is the CA dot address ID, yeah, then you will see the address ID is null. Yeah, you see here, yeah. So there are 440 customers without the address ID, yeah. Okay, now we continue with the last one, which is the number three, yeah. Retrieve the list of the customer and product without order, yeah. So if you have the product without order together with the customer, yeah. So here we create a skeleton, we are going to get this also from the customer, yeah. Select, yeah, from sales LT customer, yeah, and then after that we're going to join, yeah. So this time join with multiple table. So the first is a sales order header, yeah. So join, and then after that sales order header, yeah, this one. Okay, after that on. And then okay, join again with the sales order ID, because we want to also get the product, yeah. So sales order, detail, sales order detail. Yep, here sales order detail. Sorry, I put in the wrong place. Ah, this one. Yeah. So between the order header and order detail, you are going to create the join, and then the last join is with the product. Yeah. Sales LT product. Okay. So this name is the condition is this one is on C dot customer ID. Okay. So this is S C, and then S O H, and then S O D. And then this one is a SP, so we create the alias first. Okay, then after that, when join with the order header, you're going to use the C dot customer ID, yeah, and then equal to the OH dot the customer ID. Auto complete, yeah, and then with the source order header, it says order detail, yeah, not header. Okay, then on the OH dot sales order ID equal to the OD sales order ID. Sales order ID. Okay, yeah, and then on the product, we're going to use the on P dot product ID equal to the OD dot the product ID. Okay, yeah, and then you put the condition, yeah, where the OH dot the sales order ID is null, yeah, so there is no order, and then you want to sort the order by the product ID. And then a customer ID. Okay, yeah, then for the column list, yeah, so I'm going to, okay, so this one is a product ID and customer ID. You have to put the alias, yeah, which is the product ID is from the P, yeah, and then after that the customer ID is from the C, yeah, like this, yeah. Okay, then yep, so the column name you have to specify. You want to get the customer ID and the product ID. C dot customer ID, and then comma P dot product ID. So that's the requirement, yeah, to get the product, customer product, with the no order, with it, which is null, yeah. So we minimize this number one, number two as well, yeah. Okay, then yep, so here number three, yeah, then include the where clause. Okay, so correction on the join, yeah, because we want to include all the customer and the products, yeah. So when you join, you have between this customer and order header, you have to change the join with the full join. Remember, yeah, full join. Add the full join on the all of this join, because we want to get everything from the left table and also from the right table, including those who does not have any matching. Yep. So you get here customer ID, yeah, product ID null. Yeah, so here, yeah, sales order ID also now. Okay, so this is the answer for the challenge 2 in the lab 3. Thanks for watching.